everybody, and today I'm going to just show you guys a whole bunch of fun things that you can do with your doll's hair. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to show you guys how to do is just make a little doll headband. So all you need is a piece of ribbon. It doesn't matter what the ribbon looks like as long as it's like the right size for a doll headband. Okay, so first you just wrap the ribbon around your doll's head to the back and then tie it in the back. Tie a little knot under her hair. You can even tie two knots if it's not secure enough with one. And then you just sort of take your doll's hair and put it around it until you like the way it's situated. So that's how you make a doll hair band. Okay, so next thing I'm going to show you guys how to do is curl your doll's hair. Now, the original idea for this was my Froggy Stuff's idea, to use pipe cleaners and hot water to make the curls stay and to use these as curlers, but I'm in no way trying to take credit for her idea. It's just she did a different roll-up, and I'm going to show you guys a different way to use the pipe cleaners to curl the hair around it so the curls will come out differently. Okay, so here's what you'll need for this project. Fuzzy pipe cleaners, not the sparkly kind, because the sparkly kind, the doll's hair will get tangled in it, so make sure that they are the fuzzy kind. You will also need scissors to cut the pipe cleaners to size, and a cup full of hot water that has been boiled in the microwave. Okay, so you're also going to need your doll, of course. Alright, so to measure the pipe cleaners, it should be about the length of your doll's hair, the pipe cleaner for the roll-up. So just measure it and then cut it to size. Okay, so next you need to part your doll's hair. Now I would need you to take a section from the side of your dolls, like all along here, from the whole side, a section just like this. So then just brush it. Now you take less or more depending on how thick you want your curls to be. I want my curls to be sort of wavy, so I'm going to use a lot of hair. So you just brush it. Next, you take your pipe cleaner, put it about right here, and twist the hair around the pipe cleaner like a spiral. Make sure to do it tightly. Just wrap it around. If you've ever used a curling iron, it's kind of like that. Just wrap it around. Make sure the ends are all tucked in and there's no hair sticking out, because otherwise the ends will look kind of frizzy. And then just secure the end with the rest of the pipe cleaner. Twist it around if you have to. Also, secure the top by putting down the pipe cleaner about where you folded it. Okay, so you just take another section of hair and repeat what I just showed you guys before. Take it and wrap the hair around. Just wrap it. Now you can also make the hair overlap each other, like instead of going like this, you could go like this. That will make the curls like tighter or looser. So just continue that. And then once again, just tie off the end and tie off the top. Okay, so I'm going to show you guys how to do it one more time just to make sure that you got it. Alright, so it has to be sideways, like this. And then just twist it. Around and around and around. I'm trying to make sure you guys can see. Okay, now just tie it off and then tie off the top. Okay, so I'm gonna finish this and then I'm gonna show you guys how to dip your doll's head in to the water. Okay, now before we dunk her head into the water, you need to take a pipe cleaner and wrap it around the curls to keep them all down so they won't come out like sticking out. So just tie that around her head just to keep the curls down and flat. Okay, now you may need a grown-up's help with this because the water is going to be hot. Now, for the water temperature, I recommend microwaving it for about 3 minutes in the microwave. Okay, so here's how you dunk your doll's head. You just take her head and just dunk it right in so all the hair is in the water. Just hold it in there for a few seconds. Just so this looks so bad, okay. Alright, so then take it out. I'd recommend having a towel on the floor so you don't get water everywhere. When you take her head out of the water, just pat it dry with a washcloth, just to get the excess water off. And then untie this thing. Now, you're just gonna let them sit for like 10 minutes, because the water has already melted the curls, so you don't actually have to wait for her hair to dry. So just wait about 10 minutes, and then we'll undo them. Okay, so it's been about 10 minutes, so now I'm going to show you guys how to take them out. So you're just going to start by taking off the first pipe cleaner and unrolling it from the top. Just gently pulling down. And you can also undo the bottom one. Now if it gets a little tangled, it's alright, just gently pull everything so you don't rip too many hairs. Okay, so that's... I undid the first one, now we're going to undo the second one. Once again, just pull the top one, undo the top pipe cleaner, and unroll from the bottom. Then just undo the bottom pipe cleaner. Next. Okay, now I think you guys got it. Now I'm just going to take these out and then I'm going to show you guys how it turned out. Okay, so once you've taken your pipe cleaners out, just gently separate the curls like this. Gently separate them. Just pull them apart with your fingers. Like this. You can also shake her head just to get them dry and get them all bouncy. Okay, so I'm just gonna situate these curls and show you guys how it turned out. Okay, so your curls will look like this. Well, actually, it all depends on your doll's hair type, which I'm gonna talk about now. Now, she has like a very rubbery, sort of sticky hair because the factory stuff has some sort of hair gel in it. So dolls like this, newer dolls, will have hair that feels like this. But older dolls, like this doll right here, she has very dry, frizzy-like hair. So if you curl this doll's hair, this kind of hair, it's drier. There is a difference if you have dolls like this. So if you curl doll hair like this, it's gonna turn out a little frizzy, so I would recommend putting hair gel in it. And then we have dolls like this, where their hair is sort of layered. So I wouldn't recommend trying to curl their hair at all, because the hair is like, it's really hard to get the curlers in, and then you can't wrap it around right, and the ends come out like frizzy. So yeah, you can do these dolls and these dolls, and usually if their hair is just straight like this, the curls will be perfect like these. Okay, so next I'm going to show you guys how to fix doll hair that kind of looks like this. Yeah, she's kind of messed up. Alright, so if you have a doll whose hair and their hair is just kind of old and frizzy and you just want it to be straight and smooth again, I'm going to show you guys how to fix it and make it like that again. So you just stick it in the same temperature hot water that we did the curls in and just sort of sway it up and down until you get it nice and soaked. And then you take it out and put it on something plastic or something that's dry and you just brush it. Now you brush like this for a while until you get all the tangles out and it's smooth again. And then, while your doll's hair is still wet, brush it down so it'll be down and it won't be sticking straight up. Okay, I'm gonna brush it down and then I'm gonna show you guys what to do. Okay, so once you've brushed your doll's hair down, I need you to take a pipe cleaner and wrap it around the neck so the hair is pushed down. So it's all like flatter in her head and it's like this. And then you dunk it in there again. So now all the hair will be down, so it won't be like sticking straight up in the air. So then you just dry it and your doll's hair will be like new. Now, this also works for, like, if you have a doll and it's been in, like, a hairdo for a really, really long time. Like, if you get a doll from the store and they have, like, and then you take it out of the hairdo and it has, like, kinks in it, like a ponytail, you just do the same thing that I just did for that, and then their hair will be straight again. Okay, so last but not least, I'm going to show you guys how to put a French braid in your doll's hair. Okay, now before we start, you can also wet your doll's hair before you do the French braid. I'm not going to, but you can to make it a little bit easier, keep flyaways out of the way and stuff. Okay, now if you're going to make a ponytail, you just start by separating 3 separate strands from your doll's head. Okay, now you just start as if you were making a regular braid. One over the other. And now, when you go to do the next one, you take some hair and you just add it to that one strand and you go over again. Just take it, get some hair from your doll's head, and then just go over again. Like this. It's just like if you were doing a regular braid, except instead of just going all the way down, you just keep adding a little bit of hair. Like this. Take your next strand, take the hair, just keep adding hair until once you've added all the hair, you just keep going down with a regular braid. And once you're done, just tie it off with a rubber band. Okay, so when you're done, it'll look like this. Now, if you want, there's ways you can make like little accessories to look like scrunchies, like this fluffy pipe cleaner. You can cut a piece of it, wrap it around where your doll's rubber band is, and it'll look like a fuzzy scrunchie. Okay, everybody, so that's it. That's how you make a headband, curl your doll's hair, straighten your doll's hair, and refurbish your doll's hair. And that's how you make a French braid and scrunchie. So I hope you guys liked it, guys. I hope you guys understood everything. I did my best to show you guys. If you have any questions, I think I can answer them in comments. I'll try and explain everything as well as I can. So thanks so much for watching, guys. Bye!